Hi folks, hope you're okay today. It's good to be with you. My name's Jason, and love to everybody out there. It's good to be with you. My website is jasonburnspreacher.com. jasonburnspreacher.com. You can get me on Facebook. There's always new videos going up there. You can get me on Twitter. I comment on current affairs, theological issues, and all sorts of issues. So you can get me on Facebook, Twitter. You can also get me on my website. Just lots of things to encourage you in your walk with the Lord, or if you're interested in researching about Christianity. I want to share with you some thoughts about textual criticism of the Quran in a debate that I had with a Muslim apologist called Shamshi. Some weeks ago now, I went to Hyde Park with a team of my friends, and I got into a debate with this Muslim apologist. And the first thing to say about this debate is that Shamshi turned the camera off. The camera was turned off at the end of the debate. So I couldn't respond to the last question, which was about the Trinity and about how we answer that as Christians. So there was a bit of dishonesty there. Secondly, there was dishonesty in that they said they'd run out of camera film, but yet Shamshi filmed a clip later on which shows that they hadn't run out of camera film. And then later on, when the video did go up, they said they wouldn't edit it, and they did edit it. They put an extra clip in it. So Shamshi and his group, they didn't tell the truth. They were lying, and that's not right, and it's not fair. In the debate, we talked about the textual criticism of the Quran, and I asked a simple question: what is the ancient manuscripts behind your personal Quran? That question was never answered by Shamshi. He waffled on about I was into Oriental scholarship, Orientalism scholarship, rather than his Muslim scholarship. He waffled on about oral tradition confirms the Quran has not changed. The first thing about this Oriental scholarship, I was on about the Cambridge Companion to the Quran. I don't rate this book. I don't think it's great scholarship, but it's the best scholarship around today in the West, okay, on the Quran. Some of the scholars are not all Western. Some of them are Muslim scholars. The point that I was trying to make is that this Cambridge Quran Companion to the Quran, a selection of essays, academics on the Quran, that they basically confirmed what the Muslims were saying, that the Quran has not changed. That's what they're saying. But yet, they also say that no Quran has ever been made by looking at all the ancient manuscripts of the Quran that we have. And there's an admittance there by these Western scholars, not all Western, but I say Western in the sense of the Cambridge Companion. And so there's an admittance that the Quran has not been produced by looking at ancient manuscripts. So this actually, on one hand, confirms Shamshi's position, i.e. the scholars are saying the Quran has not changed, but it also deconstructs Shamshi's position, because if we cannot, as the scholars are admitting, that we cannot get a Quran based on any of the ancient manuscripts that we have, then you cannot say it's changed or not. And what I was trying to get at with Shamshi is that there was a contradiction within the Cambridge Quran Companion scholars' critique or intellectual discussion on the Quran. And so for him to bang on and say, oh, you're into Orientalists, well, the Orientalists are actually confirming what you believe, so why are you attacking me like that? That doesn't make sense. My position is, these scholars of the Cambridge Quran Companion are intellectually vacuous. They won't actually criticize the Quran because they're scared of Pope's of colonialism. They sense that colonialism in the past has dominated the Arabic people, and so now they don't want to be seen as dominating. So in this post-colonialist environment, they don't want to seem to be attacking the Quran. But what that means is there's a duplicity within the scholarship of many academics in the West today, Muslim and non-Muslim, where there's not willingness to have the same critical assessment of the Quran as we do the Bible. And that's the issue that I was trying to make. And you can never say, whether you're a Western scholar or a Muslim scholar, you can never ever say, and all the Western scholars admit this, that they admit that we have never made a Quran based on any ancient manuscripts. And so the point that I'm getting at is you can never say, whether you're a Western scholar or a Muslim scholar, you can never ever say that the Quran has changed or not changed. Because we cannot look at the evidence and produce a Quran based on that evidence. That's the point. There's a massive intellectual dishonesty going on in scholarship concerning the textual criticism of the Quran. That's my point. Whether you're Western or whether you're non-Western, that's the point. Secondly, about oral tradition, there are studies been done on oral tradition. The oral tradition of scribal conventions and the documents attributed to the Prophet Muhammad by Sarah Zabi Myra. She's a PhD, and read the PhD. She says, this study of the documents attributed to the Prophet Muhammad shows the techniques of redaction, including preference for a laxity concerning verbatim reproduction, cannot be definitely divided between those belonging to oral and to written methods. An intense overlap and interchange exists between both oral and written mediums. So there, that proves Shamshi wrong. The Quran is not confirmed by oral tradition, because oral tradition is not independent of the text. End of debate. Go and read the PhD on this topic. Oral tradition, scribal convention, and the documents attributed to the Prophet Muhammad by Sarah Zabi Mirza, M-I-R-Z-A. So those are the two main points that I tackled. I did make one factual error when in the debate. I said that all our Gospels are confirmed by the Gospel of John in Ryland's Library. What I meant was is that we have an old piece of the Gospel, P45, in Ryland's Library. And because of nerves, I didn't get that out correctly. So forgive me for my mistake there. But if we're going to do textual criticism, Shamshi, there are contradictions within the Quran. Surah 7:54, 10:3, 11:7, 25:59 clearly state that God created the heavens and the earth in 6 days. But in Surah 41:9-12, the detailed description of creation proceeds adds up to 8 days. This topic also includes many Muslim responses and further discussion if you want to look at answering Islam. Allah creates the heavens and the earth in 6 days, 7:54, and many Muslims want to be modern and scientific and make that 6 cons, but then again he creates instantaneously, Surah 2, 1-17. Excuse me, there are evidences of change within the Uthman text, evidence of change before Uthman. So the Quranic text has been changed, Sahih al-Bukhari, volume 6, page 478. Before closing our study of the collection of the Quran during the Caliphate of Abu Bakr, it is important to study the brief mention made by Zayd of 2 verses, which he said he found only with Abu Khuzaimi al-Anasri. The full text of the hadith on this subject reads as follows. I found the last verse of Surat At-Tuba, repentance, with Abu Khuzaimi al-Nasri, and did not find it without anybody other than him. The verse is, verily there has come to you an apostle from amongst yourselves. It grieves him that you should receive any injury or difficulty. So there's evidence of change before Uthman, evidence change after Uthman. Shabi bi Hashab said, I asked Uthman Salama, how did the Apostle of Allah, may peace be upon him, read this verse for, his conduct is unrighteous, ina amalun gaharu salih. She replied, he read it, he acted unrighteously, ina amali gahari salih, sunan Abu Dawood, volume 3, page 1116. Ibn Asub said, the Prophet, may peace be upon him, Abu Bakr, Umar and Uthman used to read Malike Yami Adi, Master of the Day of Judgment. The first to read Malike Suamadin was Maran, Sunan Abu Dawood, volume 3, page 1019. Sakik said, Ibn Masud read the verse, now come thou, hita laka, then Shaka said, we read it, Hatu Laka, I prepared for thee. Ibn Masud said, I read it as I have been taught. It is clear to me. Sunan Abu Dawud, volume 3. So those are just some evidences of before Uthman and after Uthman, the text of the Quran is not what you're saying it was in the beginning. Uthman burnt Qurans. So you could read Bukhari, volume 23. And it says, Uthman returned his original manuscript to Hafsa. Uthman sent to every Muslim province one copy of what they had copied and ordered that all the other Quranic materials, whether written in fragmentary manuscripts or whole copies, be burnt. So if you burn the Quran, you burn the evidence. So you can never say the Quran has not changed or changed if you've burned the evidence. So the scholarship for the Quran, it's a total disgrace if we have evidence that's been burnt. It shows you're not even in the game as proper scholars. Muhammad never gave any authority to have a Quran. And it says Abu Bakr al-Sadat, sent for me when the people of Yamama had been killed. And there it goes on in the discussion that Muhammad never gave any authority for the Quran to be compiled. There are missing verses in the Quran. According to Salah Bukharik, volume 6, page 79, despite the fact that Zayed's text had been copied out and sent to 7 different cities, Zayed suddenly remembered that a verse which the Prophet had quoted earlier was missing from his text. Zayed is quoted saying that this missing verse was verse 23 of Surah 33, which says, among the believers are men who have been true in their covenant with Allah. That's J. Smith Apologies paper, May 1995. According to Jeffrey, Abu Masud's codex was different from the Uthman. There are textual variants in different ways. Number one, it did not contain the Fatiha, the opening surah of 1, nor the 2 charm surahs, Surah 113 and 114. It contained, number 2, different vowels with the same consonant text, Jeffreys 25-113. It contained Shia readings, Surahs 567, 24-35, 26-215, 33-25, 42-23, 47-29. These are chapters of the Quran and verses where there are differences in the Abu Masud Codex and the Uthman text. Surah 3:9, Masud has the way of the Hanis instead of behold the true religion of God is Islam. Surah 3:39, Masud has the Gabriel called to him, O Zechariah, instead of the Uthman reading, then the angel called to him, he stood praying in the sanctuary. So those are differences in variants within different Qurans, which Muslim scholars are not telling you. I want to recommend you read the works of Stephen Masud, And Stephen Massoud is a Christian from a sectarian Muslim background. He became a follower of Jesus in April 1973 in Karachi, Pakistan. His testimony is being published in a book called The Light, available in several languages. He has a Master of Theology and a doctorate from London School of Theology, etc. And you can get his writings on www.jesustomuslims.org. www.jesustomuslims.org. So, Shamshi, you're not debating properly because you're not actually engaging in any proper scholarship. Your own sources, your own hadiths prove you wrong. Top scholarship on oral tradition by a top scholar shows you you're wrong. The Cambridge Companion scholars actually are admitting that there has never been a Quran done based on any ancient manuscripts. The Quran cannot be verified, the text that you have cannot be verified as the exact text that Muhammad had. It cannot be verified at all. And we even actually find variants within different Qurans. But until we're able to get all these ancient manuscripts together and put them together, your claim that the Quran has not changed requires proof. And that proof is not oral tradition. Alright? A text demands textual criticism. Alright. Thank you for listening, and leave it at that. Thank you.